I'm Kaito Hayabusa, and this is my epic toy review. Say hello to the guys from Bandai America and Japan. Bloop. Pwing. Now for DJ's unboxing. I'm pretty sure it's pretty obvious. Anime Heroes. Let's do this.
For some of you guys that are new here, I'm Kaito Hayabusa, and I'm a Figma, and I like to review toys, even though I am an action figure. So, I have some SH Fig Arts, various franchise action figures by Bandai Japan, and some Bandai America Anime Heroes action figures. We're going to talk about the differences, similarities, and the awesomeness between the two, and price range, and everything else that varies. So posability and whatnot. So we're just going to compare them, have fun with them, and be like, oh, dang, that's cool. So for right now, out of the box, what the boxes look like. Bandai, ages 4 and up, warning, choking hazards, One Piece. We got Roro Zoro. And then we got, Sanji. It's a nice blue and light, baby blue and white box art. So you have some simple imaging of Sanji from later on in One Piece because he has his goatee and mustache growing. And Boosh, you have the One Piece logo. And on the back, it tells you which other three figures are available. Price, where I got them. I got these guys at GameStop. When I went, they only had the one set, so I picked them up. And even though they're priced at $19.99, they're having a sale today on all anime, Star Wars, and Marvel action figures and collectibles. So these are actually were knocked down $4, so they were only $15.99 a piece. So if you guys are looking for anime, Star Wars, or Marvel action figures and you want to save some money, GameStop has a deal right now. Take advantage of it because you're going to save some money. So like literally the price for all four of these figures was the price of one Figma. It was like $69 and some change. So I felt good when I got these four figures for the price of not him exactly, but Griffith for sure was one of those pricier Figmas because he came with so much. And Persona guy was probably like 50 or 40 when he came out. Bloodborne, whew, he was a nice one, wasn't he? Anyway, back to review out of the box. So these are the Bandai America ones, and I have to say they've gotten really better ever since they started with the Naruto franchise and the Dragon Ball Z franchises. Now these look really good, and from what I can tell, got some soft goods, and they're split, so it doesn't hinder the leg posability. And I like the fact that Zoro comes with so many swords. If you're wondering that which one to get, if you're not a huge One Piece fan, but maybe you just want to get your favorite character, Zoro is probably the best one because he comes with the most accessories, as you can see. But I kind of like that Sanji comes with an alternate foot, a whole solid foot piece for his fire kicks. It would have been cool if you got two, so you can do two fire kicks and maybe some fire punches. But hey, this is pretty awesome and sweet for the price. And Sanji's looking pretty good. Oh, and then Luffy. Oh, honestly, only thing you could ask for is maybe some longer arm pieces to recreate some of his moves. But at the same time, I can't complain because this looks really good. I also like that the hat is part of the outfit. You can't put it on because he has messy bedhead, but at least the hat's there. But oh, that simple posability, oh, those bright, beautiful colors, that really nice face sculpt, simple. Oh, and then we got Minato. Guy looks like Cloud. Also a really good thing. Comes with his signature kunai with that special thing, and he comes with some jutsu hands. Oh, it looks like he can hold Naruto's Rasengan. So if you have Naruto, I guess you can share the Rasengan with him, but I think Naruto came with a peg, like a little hole in peg for his, so it might not work unless you share the hands. But he might be able to hold Kakashi's Chidori, so that's cool. Now, here we have Kamen Rider build, SH Fig Arts, extremely posable, really awesome details, and posability. Got hinge at the feet, posability at the arms and legs. Got torso, you even got removable belt parts, got battle damage, Super Saiyan Goku, came with alternate face and hand parts up the butt, but that's the difference between these figures and the SH Fig Art lines. You're obviously going to be paying a little bit more, but you get quite a bit more accessories, and because it's from Bandai Japan, you get a higher quality product, let's say that. that's not to diminish the fact that these are not high quality, they're just really good quality at a fair price. It's like, and same thing goes for Figma's. But yeah, now that we've seen these guys out of the boxes, let's take them out and pose them.
Okay, so we got them open. Walk with me, talk with me. Yes, this is gonna be awesome. Ignore Giant Kirby. Don't worry, he's not a kaiju, he's not gonna destroy the world or anything. But yes, look at these glorious test subjects. Yes, so amazing. Now, let's go over how awesome they are. Let me just whoosh, fly over here and just pose for a second like a cool guy. Being talking about couture like a nerd. Oh yeah, okay. So, here we have Rono Zoro. So, he came with 3 katanas, 3 of them sheath, and then you have them unsheath. And you can actually, the hilts are removable. I remember I saw one of them, and there we go. So you can have him posed with them, like if he has them all unsheathed. So all 3 of them are removable like that. These, they do not come off. These are the actual swords. So he has a purple blade sword, which I'm guessing is cursed. He has an all blade one, and then he has this one. He has 2 hands to hold them, and 2 fists, so he can do fisticuffs because he's a cool pirate. So, got some. It's a ball socket on the torso, so he does hula hoop. Not a whole lot of crunch, but hey, he poses. You got double elbow joints on both arms and hinge and swivel, similar to Figma's and SH Fig Arts when it comes to the wrist joints. His head is a ball socket, so you can turn and stuff. You have some tilt, but you can't really look up or down. But that's okay, because most anime characters are usually looking directly at their foes when they're doing action stuff. And if you're wondering if this long kilt thing is gonna be a problem, the answer is no, not really. And yes, he does have double jointed knee poseability, and then he has the hinge ball socket swivel at the feet. So that's how most of these figures are. So they're pretty cool and pretty poseable. And if I had both hands free, I would totally mess around with this to show you. But I don't. But as you can see, I got him in a 50 cuffs pose, so he's ready to knock some skulls around. Then he just goes, whoosh-a. Oh yeah. Out, not too bad. About that much. That's not pretty bad. That's not bad at all, considering he has the long thing. Minato, on the other hand, he's just as poseable. But because this is paracorded, I don't know if you can take it off or not. And maybe it looks like it's a peg, but I wouldn't try it. But his legs would get out that much had it not been for that. But other than that, they kick all the way forward. So that's pretty great. So you can actually get him in some pretty good poses. And he's double jointed at the knees and the arms. And I have him with Sasuke's Chidori effect. So he can use Kakashi or Sasuke's Chidori effect. So that's pretty cool. I'm not sure about Naruto's, just because Naruto has a little hole in the palm. And the Rasengan has a little peg on the bottom of the Rasengan. Luffy is the most interesting figure here in this bunch, purely because his legs, for some reason, they can extend. You can pull them out and push them in, and it's really hard to show you, but it's because you can see how there's a peg in there, and then you can actually push it in. So you can kind of make them taller or longer. And I was wondering why they did that. And it's so the double jointed knee thing doesn't get obstructed. Because if you weren't able to pull out on the leg with that, the pant gets in the way of that poseability. But because of that, pretty good. And then same thing, ball hinge or a ball socket waist. So he gets the hula hoop action. No chest crunch, but that's okay. Really good arm poseability. I like how it's pretty much a peg ball socket. They plug it in there, and because it's a ball socket, it almost has butterfly swivel or movement, along with going up and down and then being able to rotate all the way around like that, and then double at the elbows. So got that good. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, it's pretty good considering he has the ripped shirt, but that's pretty awesome. Also, his head can pop off. You can take the hat off, and if he had slimmer hair, you might be able to pop the hat on. But it just looks so good, and for the price, considering that I missed out on the SH Fig Arts versions of some of the One Piece figures, I'm pretty happy with this.
And then Sanji, ooh yeah. Nice soft plastic for the coat. Just as poseable as Luffy. And Zoro. Like, him and Zoro have similar legs. It's just Zoro has the thing covering it behind him. But that's as poseable as Zoro's legs would be. Had I been able to show you for not for the long skirt thing, because he's got the double jointed knees. And the giant flame effect for a kick. So it's just a giant thing, it's shaped like his foot. You pull off this foot, and then you just pop it on, because it's just a ball socket thing. Let me show you real quick, because it's kind of tricky. Well, it's not tricky, but you know what I mean. Okay, so let me just do that, and then ta-da! And now I'm going to have to pop his foot back on. It's not too hard, it's pretty easy, but I need both hands to do that. And now, Kaido Hayabusa here. Action figure that is a Figma is going to tell you the difference between Bandai America action figure and an SH figure. It's Bandai Japanese action figure. Obviously, one thing to note is the scale. They're a little bit smaller, but the characters in the line tend to be pretty accurate when it comes to, like, Kid Gohan's pretty short compared to Goku and freaking Broly here is a giant compared to Goku and Sora for that matter. So the scale is pretty consistent in that sense. You got the double jointed elbows, you got really nice sculpt, you got some sharp soft good plastics, and you just got really good poseability and accuracy. Legs can go out, and then not to mention you just get a whole bunch of accessories. I have all his put away in a sandwich bag, and I don't want to pull it out because it's a mix of all his hands, the various faces, his hair, because I don't think he came with Super Saiyan 2 hair, because this is the Super Saiyan 1 look. But he came with a bunch of hands, alternate faces, and I don't think he came with Kamehameha effects, but he did come with stuff. But he has open hands, fist hands, all sorts of hands. So cool looking. It's also got those joints, and then these heads tend to be a little bit more poseable. He can actually kind of look up, he can look down, there's tilt, he can do all that for some reason. I don't know why you would want to do that though. Broly being a massive figure is actually pretty poseable. They do have the double jointed things, but they don't get as far because of the giant muscle sculpts, but it looks so cool, and this is heavy. And then rawr, detail in the eyes. Oh, there's a little bit of dust on him because I had him posed. But it's so cool, so awesome, right? All the scars, the paint all around, the skirt, soft plastic that also splits. And then you got the hinges at the toes. That's something the SH figures have that the American figures don't have sometimes, is the hinge at the toesies. Trying to straighten up your foot, Broly. You're so buff. He's too strong. Okay. And then SH figures also does other things like Kamen Rider, Power Rangers. What else do they do? They do a lot. They also do some other anime figures also. Street Fighter, Detective Conan. And then, yeah, there's a lot. But I really like their Kamen Rider and Power Ranger figures. I don't think they put out Power Ranger figures as much as they used to, but they do put out a lot of Kamen Rider and other things, but it's kind of slowed down. It depends. Oh, I know they do Ultraman and stuff too, so yeah. Then this is my favorite, Saint Seiya. Super poseable. Of course, this gets in the way, but other than that, it's still fun to play with, and you still can get him in all those cool poses you would want to get him in. Sasuke, one of my favorite Naruto characters. He's super cool and poseable. This thing doesn't get in the way because it's also designed that soft plastic good. So, yeah, get that good poseability. Anyway, that's been my toy review video. I hope you guys liked it. I hope you liked the advice. If you're a fellow collector and also like anime, Star Wars, and Marvel, and a bunch of other stuff, and you like to collect the toys, and you like to find it at a good price, I just gave you a cool tip. GameStop's having an awesome deal right now on all of those things and all collectibles. So you can save some monies, which makes you happy and makes everyone else happy, because then makes the world go round. So anyway, that's my review. Luffy's giving me the stinker. Run away! Peace.